What are the best methods for converting acyl halides into ketones? This is my first video about this transformation, which is one of the most versatile methods for preparing ketones. Although acyl halides of the four main halides are known, acyl chlorides are by far the most common acyl halide used. Acyl fluorides are more stable but much less reactive and more expensive than acyl chlorides. Acyl bromides are slightly more reactive than acyl chlorides, but also more expensive, and the very expensive acyl iodides show a rather unpredictable reactivity. So, most of the chemistry in this series of videos has only been tested with acyl chlorides, and may also proceed with acyl bromides, carboxylic acid anhydrides, mixed anhydrides, and related reagents of comparable reactivity. This video is about the Friedel-Crafts acylation, that is, the direct acylation of arenes or heteroarenes by electrophilic substitution of a proton. Central to the synthesis of structurally complex organic compounds is the formation of carbon-carbon bonds. And Friedel-Crafts acylations, first reported in 1877, are one of the easiest and most common methods for making carbon-carbon bonds. Friedel-Crafts acylations are popular because they are a simple way to form C-C bonds and also because the resulting ketones are valuable target compounds and useful synthetic intermediates that can be readily converted into a huge number of different types of compound. For instance, ketones can be reduced to alkanes by the Clemmensen or Wolff-Kirchner reduction, or to alcohols or amines by catalytic hydrogenation or with borohydrides. Ketones also undergo condensation with aldehydes or other ketones and react with carbon nucleophiles to yield tertiary alcohols. Treatment of ketones with titanium or other carbene complexes can yield olefins, and the alpha alkylation of ketones can be achieved, for example, by treating a ketone enolate with a soft alkylating agent, such as an alkyl iodide. Although some arenes are sufficiently electron-rich to react directly with acyl halides, most Friedel-Crafts acylations require either catalytic or stoichiometric amounts of an acid to proceed to completion. This acid enhances the electrophilicity of the acyl halide either by coordination to the oxygen atom or to the halide. In the classical Friedel-Crafts acylation, stoichiometric amounts of aluminum chloride are used, which can convert acyl chlorides into acylium tetrachloroaluminates. The extent of acylium ion formation depends on the solvent used and is only low in apolar solvents. Which of the many possible activated acyl halide derivatives ultimately attacks the arene depends also on the degree of resonance stabilization of the acylium cation and on the reactivity of the arene. For some unreactive arenes or well-stabilized acylium cations, the actual attacking species may be a dication formed from the acylium cation and an excess of aluminum chloride. Acylium cations, where the corresponding R group may form an unreactive carbocation, such as those derived from phenyl acetic acid or pivalic acid, readily decarbonylate and can cause the formation of alkylated instead of acylated arenes. The standard Friedel-Crafts acylation requires the use of stoichiometric amounts of aluminum chloride because the product is a complex of the ketone with aluminum chloride. Ketones are stronger Lewis bases than acyl halides, and the complex of the ketone with aluminum chloride does no longer mediate the acylation reaction. If a given arene is highly reactive, catalytic amounts of an acid can be sufficient to provide for a complete conversion of the starting materials. In this case, a slight activation of the acyl halide will bring about its addition to the arene, and even the liberated hydrogen halide can further accelerate the reaction. It is difficult to perform precise kinetic measurements of Friedel-Crafts acylations because aluminum chloride does not always dissolve completely and solids often precipitate during these reactions. There is, however, a good correlation between the relative rate of Friedel-Crafts acylations and the relative rate of the solvolysis of cumyl chlorides shown on this slide. Thus, alkoxy, alkyl, and phenyl groups enhance the reactivity of benzenes, in particular in the para and orto positions. Silyl groups and the halides are deactivating but still para-directing. Fluorobenzene reacts at the para position even faster than benzene, what is due to the similar size and good overlap of the filled sp3 orbitals at fluorine and the pi orbitals of the phenyl group. The strong electron withdrawing effect of the low-lying carbon-fluorine sigma star orbital is transmitted through sigma bonds and only affects the orto and meta positions, but hardly the 4 position. The other halides are much larger than fluorine and their bonds to carbon longer, so that the filled sp3 orbitals cannot enhance the reactivity of the para position as effectively as fluorine does. Finally, ammonium, carboxyl, acyl, trifluoromethyl, cyano or nitro groups are strongly deactivating and meta-directing because these groups have no free electron pairs to push into the pi system of the phenyl group. The most prominent advantages of the Friedel-Crafts acylation are the low price and ready availability of the starting materials. Although most arenes can be acylated at various positions, Friedel-Crafts acylations often proceed with high and predictable regioselectivity, and high yields of ketones can be attained. Because acyl groups strongly deactivate arenes, twofold acylations by an excess of acyl halide are almost never observed. Most Friedel-Crafts acylations proceed at room or reflux temperature and do not require inert gas or otherwise demanding reaction conditions. Problematic, in particular for large-scale preparations, is the formation of stoichiometric amounts of inorganic waste. Then the reaction conditions are strongly acidic, also because of the release of hydrogen halide, what can cause the formation of insoluble salts and all kinds of acid-mediated transformations. Unfortunately, few solvents are compatible with these strongly acidic reaction conditions. With reactive arenes that already react at room temperature, dichloroethane or dichloromethane can often be used, but even dichloromethane will start to decompose and convert arenes into diaryl methanes under forcing conditions. Other potentially useful solvents include nitromethane, nitrobenzene, and sulfolane. Nitromethane and nitrobenzene are strong oxidants and have caused many explosions and should better be avoided. Carbon disulfide was often used in the past, but it is difficult to handle safely because of its high flammability. This is one such old example conducted in carbon disulfide. A good yield of the pure para isomer was obtained. This reaction also works well with acetic anhydride, but more than 2 equivalents of aluminum chloride are then required because the released acetate also consumes Lewis acid by complexation. This does not happen when using acyl chlorides as electrophiles. Because of the lack of suitable solvents for Friedel-Crafts acylations, one common strategy is to use an excess of the arene as a solvent, as in the example on this slide. Again, only a slight excess of aluminum chloride was enough to provide for a high yield of the expected diketone. 2 potential byproducts of this synthesis are naphtoquinone and the products resulting from Friedel-Crafts alkylation of benzene by the electron-deficient double bond. None of these were observed, however. One problematic group of starting materials are the halides of pyridine carboxylic acids or of other acids with basic functional groups. During the preparation of these acyl halides, for instance by treating carboxylic acids with thionyl chloride, the acyl halides are obtained as hydrochloride salts, which are insoluble in most arenes or the common solvents used for Friedel-Crafts acylations. One way to use these acyl halides for acylations consists in preparing a melt of these salts with aluminum chloride and a minimal amount of DMF, as shown here. This is another example of a basic starting arene, but in this case, the solubility of the amine hydrochloride in dichloromethane was sufficient to allow the reaction to proceed. alkyl arenes readily react with electrophiles, and Friedel-Crafts acylations of such arenes almost proceed without catalyst. Because polyalkyl arenes may isomerize in the presence of strong acids, the acylation of such arenes should be performed with as little catalyst as possible. In the example on this slide, only a small amount of iron oxide was used as catalyst and no isomerization occurred. In this case, the ketone was not isolated but oxidized directly to the target benzoic acid with a haloform reaction. In this acylation of metaxylene, however, a large amount of an ortho-xylene derivative resulted. This isomerization was caused by the high reaction temperature required to bring about a two-fold Friedel-Crafts acylation. Intermolecular two-fold acylations are very rare and require a reactive arene and forcing conditions. Intramolecular two-fold acylations, however, are easier to accomplish, for instance, in the preparation of anthraquinones from phthaloyl dichloride. The strongly acidic reaction conditions of Friedel-Crafts acylations can cause plenty of side reactions. For instance, if an excess of arene is used, and this arene is electron-rich, it may undergo Friedel-Crafts alkylation by the initially formed ketone to yield either tertiary alcohols or olefins, as in the example on this slide. Aryl ethers can be cleaved during Friedel-Crafts acylations, in particular when the acylation occurs in the ortho position of the alkoxy group. It seems that the close proximity of an alkoxy group to the aluminum chloride ketone complex facilitates this cleavage reaction, probably through chelate formation as sketched here. Electron-rich arenes and heteroarenes, such as furanes, pyrroles, or thiophenes, may also oligomerize in the presence of strong acids. Therefore, Friedel-Crafts acylations of such compounds should be conducted with as little acid as possible. A number of functional groups can be cleaved by strong acids or may be activated and react as electrophiles with an arene. In the presence of strong acids, amides and sulfonamides may be suitable acylating and sulfonylating reagents, as illustrated by the example shown here. Haloarenes may isomerize or disproportionate in the presence of strong bases or acids. It has been shown that aluminum chloride can convert bromobenzene into a mixture of benzene and polybromobenzenes, in particular in the presence of traces of water. Therefore, when bromobenzene is acylated, occasionally phenyl ketones are obtained as byproducts. Their formation can be suppressed by keeping the reaction temperature as low as possible and enhancing the reaction time, as in this example. 80 hours is, however, a bit too long, in particular for industrial processes where reaction time is an important cost factor. In this case, it may be more reasonable to shorten the reaction time by increasing the temperature and to find a suitable recrystallization method to remove the byproduct. Strong electrophiles, such as acyl halides and acylium cations, are usually also capable of oxidizing by single electron transfer or by hydride abstraction. Tertiary amines, for instance, are often oxidized to imenium salts by phosgene or trifluoroacetic anhydride. Decaline, although devoid of double bonds, can also be acylated under the conditions of Friedel-Crafts acylations. It is assumed that this reaction is initiated by hydride abstraction and proceeds as sketched here. The secondary alcohol and chloride result from hydrolysis and nucleophilic ring opening of the initially formed cyclic enol ether. Similarly good hydride donors as decaline are isopropyl arenes, cycloalkyl arenes, alkyl amines, and secondary ethers. All these may yield unexpected byproducts upon treatment with acyl halides and Lewis acids. In addition to the already mentioned isomerization of alkyl arenes, other potential side reactions of Friedel-Crafts acylation include the cleavage of cyclopropanes and the conversion of ketones into vinyl chlorides. Then, a number of accidents have been reported when using nitromethane as solvent for Friedel-Crafts acylations. A detonation occurred, for instance, when attempting to acylate ethylene in an autoclave with a mixture of aluminum chloride and nitromethane. The sensitivity of nitromethane may also be further increased by traces of transition metals. So, it's probably a good idea to avoid this solvent, in particular when dealing with readily oxidizable starting materials. Here's a list with some recent examples of Friedel-Crafts acylations, but many more have been reported. It's just a great reaction. Olefins may also be acylated to yield either 2-chloroalkyl ketones or alpha-beta unsaturated ketones, and examples can be found in the given references.